Hey, this is Pastor Patrick here in the Philippines. I'm making this video, and I'm wearing this red shirt specifically because the Lord, God Almighty, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, El Shaddai, the God Almighty, El Elyon, the Most High God, has instructed me to wear this shirt as a symbol of warning. That's what the blood moons that are going to be happening, this tetrad of blood moons, is a warning to Israel. Now, I'm going to put a chart under here that someone made that shows you that these tetrads are a rare thing. These four blood moons on different holidays, Passover, and I believe it's the Feast of Tabernacles. Anyway, all those details doesn't matter to this video. The point is that there are patterns that God follows. Patterns. As he says in Genesis, he gives us, you know, signs in the sun, moon, and stars. And this is a sign of warning to Israel. Now, my friends, I know that you guys, Israelites, people in Israel, have peace because God has put his protection. Archangel Michael is the prince over the nation of Israel, it tells us in the book of Daniel. But there is this king of fierce countenance who will rise. But before that, at this time, it's time for what we call the War of Gog and Magog from Ezekiel chapter 38 and 39. God himself will defend Israel. For the he who defends Israel neither slumbers nor sleeps. And he will defeat 5 out of 6 of these armies. And the whole world will know there's a God in Israel. This issue with the Muslims and all this stuff is going to be knocked off its feet as God will destroy 5 out of 6 of the enemy's military himself, as the Bible tells us in Ezekiel 38:39. But listen, there is great deception coming, and a man of peace, or the man of sin, as it tells us in the New Testament. He's coming, as it tells us in Daniel 9:26-9:27. He's coming to confirm a covenant with many. He will come to bring a peace deal to even now they're trying, but it's not the Lord's time yet. Well, they try to even release this spy, Pollard. It's been going on and on for 20, 30 years. Trying to make all kinds of deals. But after this war of Gog and Magog, which I believe is signaled by these blood moons, there's a man of deception who is coming. There is the man of sin, of lawlessness, who will come with a false peace to allow Israel to rebuild their temple. And of course, this will all come to pass because the Lord God Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, said it would happen. And this great deception is coming from these, the second heaven. This is coming from, some people see them as these aliens, UFOs and all that. But actually, it's just one of many of the deceptive practices of that serpent who beguiled Eve in the garden, Satan himself. The old dragon and his minions are going to be given, they've been given spiritual authority now for all this time over the souls of men and through manipulating governments of the world. But the capstone of the kingdom of Satan will be the Antichrist, we call him the son of perdition, son of destruction. That word is apollonia in Greek, the son of destruction, or in Hebrew, Abaddon, son of destruction. He is going to come, and with the olive branch, with peace, through NATO, through the UN, something like that, through the European Union, from the old Roman Empire, the same Roman Empire that persecuted Israel. And, the people who destroyed the temple, it tells us in Daniel. It says, the prince of the people who destroyed the temple, which Daniel wrote in about 650 B.C., 600 B.C., excuse me, maybe 580 B.C. I got so much in my mind. Excuse me. The exact date doesn't matter. Let's just say around 580 B.C. Daniel wrote that, what the angel Gabriel told him. But the future event, the temple was destroyed in A.D. 70, as you guys know from the Emperor Titus, who became the General Titus. You know, he became an emperor later on. So the Roman Empire, the NATO, European Union, these are the people from whence the prince will come to bring a death sentence to this world, to the world and the flesh. A death sentence with a false peace treaty that's coming. That's the real warning. And deception. Mass deception is coming, of mind control and all this kind of stuff. Through this, lots of people will be seeing these aliens and all that. But really, they're shape-shifting reptilians, as some of these New Age people call it. Demons, snakes, brood of vipers. They're coming. They are coming, and they're going to be let loose by the Most High God as judgment upon this world and evil, as even as the angel Gabriel told Daniel to put an end to sin, to bring about the everlasting covenant. It's the birth pains of the earth, the creation is in travail, that the Messiah would be revealed, that the Messiah would return at the end of that 1-7 period, the period of seven years, times a time, times and half a time. That's half, the second half, when this, what we call the Great Tribulation. And there's that 7-year covenant that will be made. That is the great deception. It's coming. So if you are an Israelite, take heed unto yourselves. Be prepared. Only accept the pure word of God. Now, I am a Christian. So, of course, as a born-again Christian, as a follower, and accepting that Yeshua is the Messiah, Yeshua of Nazareth, Jesus of Nazareth, we accept him as the Messiah. Through the pure prophecies and the pure word of the Old Testament, it points us to one man, that he came from Bethlehem. All of the prophecies, should do a video on that. Jesus fulfilled those prophecies. Isaiah 53, many rabbis tell their people, don't read the end, the last few verses of Isaiah 52 and then Isaiah 53. Why? Because it tells of the suffering Messiah, the suffering servant. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities and the chastisement of our peace. The withholding of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. That's not Israel. There's rabbis who say that's talking about Israel. No! It's the Mashiach, the Messiah, that's being referred to in that text. It is Jesus who is the Christ, the Son of the living God. Imagine this, even though God says that you would have ears to hear but cannot hear, and eyes to see but cannot see, until the time of the Gentiles is fulfilled. That's what's coming. The true born-again Christians will be removed from the earth. Don't be deceived when you see, the Pope's still here, the Catholics are still here, all these old mainline denominations, they've fallen away. Even all these guys, Kenneth Copeland and all that, all across the broad spectrum of Christianity, or Christendom, there's tons of people who are not really Christians. They are weeds in the garden of God. And they will be exposed when they are left behind, when the true church is removed. The true bride of Christ, of the Messiah, is removed. Do not be deceived by these false teachers who will be left behind, these wolves in sheep clothing. They're about to be exposed. They're going to be coming with all lying signs and wonders to try to destroy, to kill, steal, and destroy Israel. Listen to me, Israelites. There is a group of Israelites who only use the Tanakh, the Old Testament. I challenge you, do not use all of these extra biblical texts, for God himself will write it on our hearts, he tells us. Behold, the days are coming when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel. That's what the Lord said in his word in the Tanakh. I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel. Everyone that calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. That's what God promised in the Tanakh to his people, a new covenant with the house of Israel. He promised in Zechariah chapter 1, I will once again choose Jerusalem. I will once again show mercy. That's what's been happening for the last 150 years, really, but particularly since 1947, 1948, 1967, 1973, the Yom Kippur War of 56, the war in the Sinai Desert against the Egyptians and all that. God has given favor, and grace on the house of Israel. Zechariah chapter 12, verse 10. He would pour out a spirit of supplication on Israel. And they will mourn for the one they pierced as one mourns for an only begotten son. That's Yeshua. When he returns at the end of this 7-year tribulation period that's coming upon the earth, as it's called the time of Jacob's trouble. Listen to me, please. I beseech thee. The Lord showed me in a dream last night. The secret for you not to be deceived is only one way. That is the pure, living Word of God. Don't even, if you don't want to accept that Jesus is the Messiah today, I understand, because the Word of God says that only a remnant of Israel would accept Jesus as the Messiah. But the Lord said, if you will take the pure, living water of His Word, you will not be deceived. So if you take the Tanakh, the Old Testament, as we call it, Gentiles call it, the Old Testament, but the book, the Bible, if you take the Bible only as your source of wisdom and understanding and relationship with God, God will protect your mind from the coming deception. But if you open your mind and instead of drinking pure water, and you decide, hey, I want to drink some coffee, I'll take the Word with some Roman Catholicism. You know, I'll let the Pope come make a peace deal, and I think it's great that we will, build a church for all nations on the Temple Mount, and then, you know, we'll let the Vatican be in charge between the Muslims and the Jews. You're drinking coffee or tea and not the pure living water of God. Get your Tanakh and nothing else, and stand in the Tanakh, so that in that day when you see the abomination that causes desolation spoken of by Daniel the prophet, when you see this man of peace, the man who made the peace deal, go into the temple after he kills these two troublemakers, these two radicals, these two witnesses standing in front of the temple, when at the base of the Temple Mount, when he kills them, and he goes into the temple and declares himself to be God, just like during the time of the Maccabees. What Epiphanes the Fourth did there in about 165 BC, claiming himself to be God, sacrificing a pig and setting up a statue of Zeus. This man will set up a statue of himself. Maybe Apollo or Apollyon, he'll set up a statue in there. When you see that, because you're rooted and grounded in the Tanakh, you will flee to Petra, as a matter of fact, to Basra, and God will protect you there. That is the time of that times and half a time, 3.5 years, when the Lord will once again feed his flock of Israel with manna from heaven, water from the rock. And that rock has always been, as Daniel's interpretation of Nebuchadnezzar's dream, that rock that's cut from the mountain, not made with hands, that destroys the kingdoms of this world and becomes a mountain and fills the whole earth. That rock has always been the Messiah, and that rock has always been Yeshua HaMashiach. In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Hallelujah, hallelujah, the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world, the blood over the doorposts of your heart that lets the destroyer, Apollyon, pass over you and your family when you're covered by the blood of the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. Put your faith in Yeshua as your salvation. God bless.